So I got a lot of responses on my video. Is it wise to go all in where I share that I'm planning to do that? A lot of long-time followers are warning me not to do that, and I will try to make the case why I do think it's a wise decision. But first, I'd like to read one comment that really stands out for me from Christian Cool. Great video, Mark. I respect all you have accomplished and admire your passion and courage to invest in crypto. However, I don't think it is smart to go all into crypto. You can go most in and still achieve your objectives. Many say that you can go 80, 90%. What's the difference going 100% or 80%? Like, you will make as much money or almost as much, but if it fails, you still have that very, very valuable 10 to 20% left to, well, get back up. So that's a good point. So don't risk everything. Playing the risk reward can be dangerous if not combined with probabilities, he says. The likelihood of crypto going to zero is still much higher than most other asset classes. There is a ton of research showing that being grateful for what you have, as opposed to what you could have, is the main contributor to happiness and even longevity. You seemed very happy when you told about your baby in the prior video. Every day I'm grateful for being a father, much more so than for the crypto I have in my wallet. And I think that's a great point. This is also many other followers and commenters also say that, like, yeah, when you're later in life, it's much harder to make back the money that you possibly will lose. These people that go all in their companies are usually young people that don't have much to lose. Like, if it fails, they can like rebuild it very quickly. But if you fail and lose everything you've built up for the past decades, it's gonna take you a lot longer. And also, you have responsibilities now, a baby. So of course, what you gonna do if you lose it all? Very good points. And of course, it's true that the likelihood for a crypto to fail or to go to zero is much higher than for gold, for example, to go to zero, or for a stock index to go to zero. Of course, that's probability is indeed much higher with crypto. So that's all true. I'm still convinced it's the right choice to make for me, and of course, this is a personal decision. You really have to invest according to what feels right to you and what you're comfortable with. You should never, never invest beyond your level of comfort, I think, because it's just that the markets are so tricky that they will for sure go the other direction than you are hoping. And if you went, if you overinvested, well, you are very likely to make these big mistakes of selling on a panic sell, or just becoming afraid and or becoming irresponsible and saving whatever you can save at the worst possible time. So overinvesting is never smart, and so you should really basically investing is a lot about education and building up confidence and knowledge, and only the, you should also invest in co according to the levels that you have achieved, and not overinvest because someone else is doing it, because you don't have the foundation to do so, and so someone else may succeed where you might fail. But for me, I'm just sharing like why I feel it's right for me. So last bull market, I invested 80% into crypto, and I still had this mentality that most of my followers also have now today, is that you should at least keep some at this on the side because you never know, and that's also what I thought. And so what I did was, I felt like I invested a lot. So the moment the market started to go up, I started diversifying quite quickly. It went from 200 to $400 or 600 or $500, and I already started to diversify some crypto into other investments. Those ha that have been following me, for example, remember that I also invest in a startup at the time with a piece of my crypto, did some other stuff, invest again in some gold, And I continue to do that the whole way up, just locking in some profits into fiat. Why am I so attracted now to go all in? Because I don't want to do that again. The problem with this strategy for me was that I was continuing to build up security by and maximize, try to maximize profits by following the market intensively when it comes to prices, trying to predict it. My YouTube channel was all about that. And in the end, my returns are a lot lower than someone that went all in. Like, for example, Tyson, if you know his channel, cryptocurrency channel, went all in crypto, but also stayed all in the whole way up. Huh? And this is going all in. It's not about that you allocate 100%. That's the first big move that will, of course, bring you more profitability than going only 80% in. But the biggest difference is made that you stay all in on the way up, because you really underestimate always how high it will go, and so you end up selling way too soon your coins. Some coins are sold like before it does, after it will still do 10x or 100x. That's what happened to me. The NXT, for example, that I diversified into a startup. I remember that was 10 million NXT, and it was valued at about $100,000. Well, after that, the 10 million NXT went up to a value of $20 million. But I diversified them into investment for a value of $100,000, and only 1 year later, they went up to $20 million. So that's crazy, but that's what happens when you diversify crypto. If it doubles or triples, and you already start diversifying into other investments, yeah, well, the opportunity cost, the missed opportunity cost is huge, and this will also show in your returns, of course. So having the discipline or the strategy to stay all in is a very good strategy. Of course, the price is paid much later when you reach that peak, and you also stay all in at the top, and then you go down. Well, we just saw what happens then, and it's cut by 10 again. So that's where you make huge losses, but the profits that you will make before really make that not a problem, because whereas, like, if you use this like diversification strategy to lock in profits, let's say you will do, if you do it very well, 10x with your portfolio. But if you don't do that and you just stay all in into crypto, you can switch between crypto projects, yes, but you stay in crypto, you will do 100x with your portfolio. That's a big difference. So if after that you lose, you're cut by 10, but you first did 100x, well, you're still up 10x. That's one thing. Of course, I'm not addressing the issues here. Why I think it's justified to go all in, because it's exactly the same as deciding. Let's say we're at in December 2014, just 1 year ago when I was making the video that I think we reached the top. And let's say I would say then that I decide to go all out of crypto. Huh? Many people would have said, like, yeah, that's not a good time, you're going to go much higher, yes. But nobody would say that I'm unresponsible, or that I'm unwise, or that I'm, it would could be considered as a very, very responsible move to go all out then. But actually, it's equally unresponsible to go all out then than to go all in now. But actually, I will show to you that it's actually not it is responsible. So why do I? For me, it's justified to go all in because, okay, I think the probabilities for crypto to go up is like, let's say 90% from current valuations. So I think that most people will agree then that it's justified if you really believe that, to invest 90%. If you think that that's like a probability of 90%, it will go up a lot, and you don't have any other investments where you see that, then it is justified, at least if you follow the Kelly criterion, to also invest very big into that, and a very large allocation. And so that would be like 90% in this case. So, but this, but why do I want to go 100%? Because of the extra cost that the 10% leaves here. The 10% is a huge cost, not so much in missed opportunity financially, but in just the energy it takes from me to be to continue to be busy with that. Because that 10% has to be invested too, and it cannot be in crypto. So I need to be busy with, well, you saw the videos that I was busy with, trying to invest in non-crypto markets. It takes time too. And this is a cost that I would like to avoid, to pay. but it's more than that. If you keep this discipline of indeed having a piece of your money into fiat, it will become also a bigger problem over time. Because let's say I'm successful with crypto, goes up a lot, there will come a time where I have to say, like now my fiat is only 1 or 2% of my capital. I really need to boost it up to continue to have a piece of my capital that will protect me. And so I have to boost it up again to 10% and have a new fiat investment problem to deal with. And I think it's actually a very big problem. I have just been studying these markets again. Buying these assets is very actually difficult. For example, Interactive Brokers, I'm using this platform, is very unuser-friendly. And of course, you can choose more user-friendly brokers, but then you pay very high fees. So it all requires quite some study to do these things. And investors that invest in the traditional fiat markets also have lots of communities on the internet where you see that people also put a lot of time into that. So I will also have to put time into that. In my case, the portfolio I was building was a mixture of gold and gold mining stocks following Roland Van Damme, analyse.be's portfolio, which requires me to read newsletters every 2 weeks, study the new positions he takes in to copy them, as well as manage then what I was also setting up was a permanent portfolio, but actually I was more setting up a value portfolio where it was a mixture of gold, but also actually the gold part was this Roland Van Damme portfolio, and then the stocks part I was setting up a mixture of emerging market stocks. And then it's also like I'm a value investor, so I need to study these things. I don't want to like just do a permanent portfolio with equal share. No, I want to invest like so that the best risk reward ratio has the highest exposure. This all is the way I invest, but it all requires time. So if I decide to not go all in, I do have to do all that and continue to do all that and continue to follow up all that and continue to build out that portfolio. Yeah, I don't want to pay that price because that energy goes lost too. Like I want to transfer that energy into another activity, which is helping to build out these coins. So if I go all in, then I can really focus on just a few coins, maybe only Bitcoin Cash next year, and then maybe after I can focus again on Bitball and maybe Bismuth, or maybe kick a coin out and replace it with another coin if I don't like it for how the projects are going. But I can limit my attention to only a few projects, and I can start really focusing on helping these projects become successful. That's what I really want to do. And if you look at who does that now in the crypto markets successfully, well, not so many people, but Roger Ver really stands out and has inspired me also, because he is the first one that ever did that, go all in into crypto and had some amount of capital when he entered crypto in 2011. And Since then, he has really focused on marketing the coin, like evangelizing it. And this, yeah, this has been extremely profitable for him, but also extremely effective. The amount of work that he has achieved, the amount of evangelism that he has achieved, and the amount of usage, utility that he has given to these coins by using it left and right every day, is tremendous. And he could never have done that if he would have like a piece of his portfolio invested still in fiat markets.
Because there is great value in cleaning up things. Let's turn things around. Let's say that I want to exit crypto, and I wanted to exit at the top. And at December, when I made the video that I think we have a top here, I also shared that I went to a minority crypto. I still have 10-20% in, because you never know, it can go up. That's what a rational investor would do. But let's say that I say then, like, actually, even though it can go up more, I really want to leave this market, and so I'm going to not sell 80%, but I'm going to sell 100%, and I'm going fully out, because even though it can go up more, I really want to start focusing on the other investments, and I really want to like clean up my crypto holdings and just get out fully, so that I can focus on my new investments. Everybody would say like, okay, makes sense. It's not irresponsible. But actually, it's equally irresponsible, because you never know how high something can go, and so you should actually leave like 10 or 20% in. But everybody would understand, like, yes, actually, it's good to go. I understand, because he really wants to focus on something else. And of course, it does take energy to leave a certain amount of money in the market. And okay, worst case, he misses some profits there, but probably will make up for that by focusing on his new activity in life. It's the same here, but in the other way around. I find that if you want to live the fiat lifestyle as well as the crypto lifestyle, it requires a lot of energy, and I just don't have that energy. So if I decide now to go, instead of 80 or 90% to crypto, 100%, it really like it's really a switch out of a system, from the fiat system, which has involves banks, brokerages, study of these markets, and study of these banks. And if you can just say like, you know what, fuck all that, I'm just out and I never come back, that makes life a lot easier, because okay, it means that you can just empty all your accounts there and basically close them all, and you go to crypto, and then you can focus on crypto, which is just a huge task on itself. Also, like, securing crypto is a lot of work. Every coin has some different system. Keeping on top of what happens in every coin, it's a lot of work. And if you don't want to also build it, help really like build it out, it's a full-time job, even if you only do one coin. So but you can do that if you indeed like leave the old system. You have much more energy and time to do that. But if you are still hooked up in the old system, it will require time for you too. And the question is, of course, is it worthwhile here? And I don't think it's worthwhile to stay hooked into the old system. I really don't. It's true, as Christian Kuhl says, that the chance for crypto to go down to zero is much higher than the chance for stock indexes or gold to go down to zero. That's true, but how high is it? Because in my opinion, it's, well, let's say that the chance for crypto to go to zero is maybe like 1%, whereas for gold it's like 0.0001%. It's much lower, it's true, but it's already low for crypto also. Like, crypto, the chance that crypto will fail is very, very low. Why? Because it's the same as saying that cars will fail. Yeah, in the beginning, cars were slow, and some were even slower than a horse. But you could clearly see that that's the future, because it's so much better, and over time it will go much faster than a horse and much more easier to maintain. Or the same with the internet. Like, yeah, in the beginning it was very unuser-friendly, that's true, but For someone who uses his brain and looks at at history, he can clearly see that actually the internet sooner or later will become very big. What you just need is better, more user-friendly applications or websites and websites that actually can really improve your life, that make life easier than the brick and mortar life. But that will all come over time. It's the same with cryptocurrency. So it's very clear that, of course, you can have great innovations in cryptocurrency that may wipe out the competition. That's true. So betting on a single coin is much more risky than betting on the whole crypto market. That's true. I think most people can agree that, yes, chance for cryptocurrency, the whole market, to go up a lot in value over the next 10, 20 years is, compared to these traditional markets, is the chances for that is extremely high. It's like 90% sure this will happen. And in my opinion, I would say 99% sure that it will happen. Of course, which coins, that's much more difficult. But this market in general, yes. So that's how I also invest then. Indeed, I think it's worthwhile for me to indeed take that extra step, which you could call the irrational step, where you say like, no, like even though you say it's like on 90% chance, you don't go 90, you go 100%. And so that 10% chance that you fail, you're actually not hedging against. And that's something I'm willing to do. But I would not call it 10%, I would call it maybe 1%. But yeah, it just feels right to me. Then of course you could give the criticism that, yeah, but you're going in on one coin, so that's even more risky. Like, what is the chance that your coin that you select, Bitcoin Cash, will be will do well? Like, within the industry, some will really fail. So betting everything on that is totally irresponsible. And I would say to that. Of course, I'm not doing that fully. It's not 100%, but it's like right now with my crypto portfolio, it's indeed 90% or 95% Bitcoin Cash and only 5 or 10% other coins. That's true. But that's just given the market situation. That's not a static thing. Over time, I plan to change that. If Bitcoin Cash is successful and goes up to compared to other coins, I will diversify some into other crypto projects. But also, I think that it's the same as saying someone who says, like, yeah, I'm going all in on this internet thing in 1995, and then he's betting a lot on one company. Is that irresponsible? Well, actually, in the first phases of the market, go up a lot. That's just typical for a new economy. That's pre-mass adoption, and that's very likely will go towards mass adoption. You will very likely get a bubble where everything goes up in value, even the things that are actually losers and will end up losing the market completely. I do think that it's just a given that the adoption in cryptocurrency has gone up a lot in 2017. Maybe 5 to 10% of people have invested in it, but over time, it will become much, much, much higher, and so we're still in early adopter phase here, and so yeah, we will get the masses join sooner or later, and massive bubbles where everything will go up, even the losers. So I think it's not yet irresponsible to bet on only one coin big. And the most important thing I think to say here is that, well, the people that really made it big in crypto went all in. That's what I have seen. I've seen certain people go all in and stay all in. And the returns they made was much, much, much higher. They built from nothing, or 5 or 10,000. They became millionaire. I think that's very admirable. And they all focused heavily on a certain coin, with the exception then of Taizen, who indeed has a very diversified portfolio. It's a different strategy. But yeah, the people that really made from, I have the massive returns, that's what they did. And that also contributed the most to the cryptocurrency industry or to that certain coin that they select, all went all in. And so that's what I've seen, and that's what I started wanting to do too. And yeah, I do think it is responsible, but only if you are ready to do, if you feel ready to do something like that. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, it made a little bit more sense where I'm coming from, and thank you all for warning me. I really appreciate that very much. Like sometimes I do, like it can be very helpful to have a friend say when they disagree on a certain action you take. And that's how I feel with many people of you, and I really appreciate that. But yeah, I'm going to be very stubborn on this one and do it.